Hi, my name's Tony Phillips. I'm the historian for the Mendocino Coast Model Railway and Historical Society. Today we're standing outside the building which houses our new layout. The noise which you can hear in the background is the Fort Bragg skunk train waiting to depart for its daily journey. Today we have a steam train, number 45, pulling the consist of coaches, all of which are well over 100 years old. The building behind me is of itself over 100 years old. It's what they called the Carpenter's Barn. And as you will see, we now have solar power here. Solar power we use to charge two deep cell marine batteries, which in turn provide the motive power for both the track and the battery power that we use on the trains. We're now inside the Carpenter's Barn, which is an 105-year-old building and was the place where the old California Western Railroad used to repair the freight cars and the carriages that ran on the skunk train. I'm going to take you on a tour of our layout, some 6,500 hours worth of work, still incomplete, but give you some idea of what we're up to and what we hope to achieve when we're finished. We're going to take our tour using our battery-powered steam engine with the Mendocino Coast Railroad and Navigation insignia along the side. And operator Jim is now going to set our train going, and we'll follow her around. Our train is now going through the tunnel, which will be underneath a hill, which will contain our logging camp. If you look up towards the, about 4 feet up, you'll see that we have track, and that will be the ridge line. The ridge line was where the logs were brought to on the 10-mile basin, and they were brought to an incline, which is the board that you see to the left. And the lumber, the logs, was lowered down the incline to a loading area, and from there the wood was taken into the mill. So, as you can see, we're still massively into construction. This particular piece of the track is about 50 inches above the sea level, as we see it. So our train Ernestine is now leaving the underside of the hill where our logging camp will reside and coming out to stop on the high trestle that will be over the big river at Noyo. We will cover the window that you see at the back here with a backdrop and install a dam kind of similar to the one that they used to call Hell's Gate Dam on Big River. And if you look down in front of it, you can see where the bridges are going to be carrying the main line across Big River. The area we're now looking at is going to be completely covered in trees, either an area that has been logged or that is waiting to be logged. And the train will pass down here, Jim, on its way to be crossing over the Noyo River here in Fort Bragg. We're now following the train as it comes down and around the curve in the northwest corner of the building. The train's now approaching the taller of the two Howe Truss bridges that we have going over what will be our recreation of the Noyo River here in Fort Bragg. At the top, where you see the open wood, there will be a high line, a line carrying logs, from there to a landing area down where the houses are that you've just passed. Stop, Jim. What you're now looking at is the engine house, and the area in front of it will contain our water tank, our ash pit, and other buildings that are associated with ministering unto the engines. The drop at the back will have a road running along it, and it will be a logging road covered with high trees. So, Jim, if you can take our train round the corner to where we will find Fort Bragg. Now the train is going to pass in front of the town of Fort Bragg, over here. We don't have enough room for the full town, so on a temporary basis we went around town and took photographs of all the buildings which we know existed either at the time of the 1906 earthquake or were built very soon thereafter. And we've put those along a background of the scenery that you can normally see from Fort Bragg. Now, if you come down to the lower level, which is round here, you'll see we've incorporated another feature which we took from the Albion Lumber Company Railroad, which is a switchback. There were two switchbacks running along to the tail here and then back down to the main line. This enables us to connect the forest line with the main line using something that actually did exist here on the coast, which were the two switchbacks at Albion. We're now at the Fort Bragg Skunk Depot. And if you look at our real depot, which is just across the road, just across the tracks from where I'm standing, and our model, you'll see that they're pretty close. Our model maker, Jeff Pratt, did an incredible job in building our model of the Skunk Train Depot. So, as you can see Ernestine coming back in view, we have the ability to run this particular train non-stop through a dog bone loop which extends some 80 feet in length. I'm now standing by the mill pond that we have created for our mill. As usual, all these things have problems, and when we created our mill pond, it leaked with disastrous consequences. Here you see a 2662 crossing another of our Howe Truss bridges. This 2662 is a spitting image of the locomotive that used to run at the Casper Lumber Company. Behind me, over at the back, is our creation of the slag burner. This is where all the chips of wood were built. And behind me to the right here is our mill. Our mill doesn't yet have the ability to pull logs out of the pond, or in fact for the train to be able to deliver the logs into the pond. But those items are under construction. Down here in front of me, coming across that small A-frame bridge, will be a recreation of the Pudding Creek log pond, which was the first log pond in this area, which will contain the dike which held back the waters to hold the logs. What we have here, as you can see, is the front of the mill, and this has been beautifully weathered by one of our members. We're trying to combine three scenes into one here. One of them, the objectives, is to have as many trains running as possible automatically whilst the layout is operation, so that visitors can see lots of action. So the Little River Logging Company runs from the pier all the way down to the engine house and back, and the other two trains are pulling stuff out of the lumber yard and taking it to the pier. The pier, unfortunately, is a mere 5 feet long. We wanted to put in a pier which represented the Union Lumber Company pier, which is close to 700 feet long. To do that, we needed to build a model pier 22 feet long. But as you can see, our building just wasn't long enough, so we had to suffice for what we have. The last piece of our layout here is our lighthouse. Now, we have two lighthouses. One is a recreation of the one at Point Cabrillo, a mere 105 years old and still working, as does ours. And this one, as you can see, is leaning on its side. Why? One of our objectives was to try and show people that this area was badly affected by the 1906 earthquake. So we decided that if we had a lighthouse which was not dissimilar to the one at Point Arena, falling over or in the process of falling over with the light still going, and a broken down old building next door with shrieks coming out of it, we might manage to convey to people that this was a very sad occasion. The town of Fort Bragg was severely leveled and would have been totally wiped out by fire had there not been a schooner in the at the pier with steam up, and water was pumped out of the sea and enabled the fires to be doused in Fort Bragg. The final piece to point out to you is, as you can see down below, there are two more tracks. These are our mainline tracks and are to demonstrate to people the Northwest Pacific link to the Skunk Train. The Northwest Pacific ran from San Francisco to Willits. People got off at Willits and then took the Skunk Train either to the Noyo River Tavern, which you can see described on our website, or came here to Fort Bragg. Our main line, or main lines, are approximately 220 feet in length, and the minimum radius on them is 5 foot 5 inches, or 10 foot 6 diameter. And that should be sufficient to enable all the steam engines that we own, even the 2662s, to be able to run with no problem whatsoever. Okay. As you can see, we're now outside the building. Over to my left is the door which keeps up the rodents when we're not running the main line. The main line, as you can see, exits out of the building and then runs down the length of the outside. So that gives us a run of about 40 feet on each side, plus the area at the north end. Here we can see two of our club members working on our model of the Pudding Creek Trestle, which is the first thing that visitors to our layout will see. It's a pretty good recreation of the real thing. There's over 1,600 Japanese bolts holding everything together, and it looks exactly like the original, except for the fact we're slightly short in the number of bents, that is, number of uprights, that there are in our trestle compared to the real thing. The area now looking at is where the train will come round from the east side of the building, along the north side, and ultimately down to the west side. The area right here, we will have a turntable and tables or extensions whereby the people who own steam engines can get their steam engines fired up and ready for action. We're now looking down behind me, and you can see just how long the building's about 55 feet long, and we'll have about 55 feet of mainline track running down the outside. So that's where we're at so far. A lot of work, a lot of energy, taken far longer than we thought, but we're real close to having our main lines running, and once they're done, then visitors will be invited to come in en masse. The real deal, as they say, will be that if you buy a ticket to ride on the Skunk Train, then you'll be entitled to come and visit the layout for no extra charge. So hopefully come Christmas, we'll see a lot of you here watching our trains and enjoying our trains the same way that we do. Thank you very much.
Let the towns drift slowly by. Listen to the steel rails humming. That's the hobo's lullaby. Now do not think about tomorrow. Let tomorrow come and go.